dark side. Yoda, why don't you join me on the dark side? Come, Yoda. Join me on the dark side.
The dark side. Destroy this enemy.
Well, Master Yoda, if that's how it must be, then only one thing can come of it. Let's do this.
What's going on, everybody? Justin from Blue Collar Survival again. Starting to get my beard back. I know I've been gone for a couple weeks from reviews, but today we're back with a new one. The Lightning OTF. So you guys, stay tuned. Alright guys, let's go ahead and get on with this review. So this will be my first OTF review. And I actually ordered this for a buddy. Mr. Cradduck asked if I would order it for him and then just go ahead and review it and send it his way. So figure I'd get this out of the way and hurry up and get this back to him. So I want to say thank you to Mr. Cradduck and thank you to EDC Gear and Pocket Knife. You guys are amazing. Hands down, one of the best groups, if not the best groups, on Facebook. Alright, so he ordered this on Grindworks.com. I believe it is running for $34.99. And actually, right now over at Grindworks, they are having a OTF sale. So definitely go check that out on Grindworks.com. But he picked this up on Grindworks for $34.99. And let's just play with it. I mean, I've been playing with this all day. I know he's ready to get into it. It has an aluminum handle. Not a deep carry clip. No lanyard hole. Solid all the way around, obviously. But man, it's got pretty decent action for a $35 OTF. Two-tone blade, which I do like that. Wonder how that paint will hold up over time on the blade there. But yeah, I mean, definitely some nice action on it. Aluminum handle, stainless steel blade. Doesn't say what it is. I imagine it's either a 3CR or a 420JC, something like that. Who knows? But, you know, it's an OTF. You're not going to use it for real hard work. 3 1/4 inch blade. Blade stock is fairly, I mean, I guess average for it. Here, let's get some size comparisons while we're at it. And I'll go ahead and throw all the specs up on the screen while I'm doing this. We'll go with a little theme today for size comparisons. So we'll start off with the little Spyderco Roadie. We'll bring in the big old Tuya Bruiser. And my paramilitary too. So pretty similar size and length to the PM2. Weight on this is 3.9 ounces. Right hand carry only. Handles 4 3/4 inches. Got an overall of 8 inches. I mean, fairly light for, you know, as boxy as it is. It's nice they have all the hardware inset only on one side. Not much grip. The aluminum handle's pretty smooth. Not much worry for this going off in your pocket either, because it's easy to play with it when it's like that, but to get it all the way up and then out. And let's see, we can do a quick demonstration just to... Now, for you that don't know out there, when something like this happens and your blade comes loose, all you have to do, that's it. So we'll go ahead and check the edge as the factory edge. And I'm ripping, this might not be the best paper. There we go. It's just my paste up, it's all good. So sharp right out of the box, there was no packing on this knife, it just came in a plastic bag. And I don't know what these holes in the bottom are for. It's the drain hole in case you get water in it or what. It looks like they would put a glass breaker on that or something, but not 100% sure. It has some, I guess what you would call jimping on the sides. Not very effective with that paint. Most any kind of jimping that has paint on it isn't very effective, aside from the when they use the bluing paint more than the regular just black shiny paint. I don't know what you would call it. No markings on it other than lightning right there. Fun little knife to play with for $35. If you're looking to get in OTFs, I mean, I know everybody says just save your money and get a Microtech or Protec, something like that. You know, those are, you're looking at dropping $200 plus easy for one of those. So, you know, something like this just to kind of get the feel. Do I really want an OTF? Is this something that I would use daily? Does it benefit me and my EDC? You know, who knows? You might get one of these and find out, hey, you know, this isn't really for me. And you're only out $35 opposed to, hey, this isn't for me. But on the same time with the, if you spend the extra money for the Microtech or something like that, easily resellable. It's just sometimes, you know, sales can be a little iffy. I mean, most sales that I do, I get references from, or I know the people from the groups and stuff like that. So, but this thing, I'll tell you what, it is a blast to play with. Since it's come in, man, I'm going to give this back to him and it's going to be worn out. A little bit of a hollow grind on the blade. I don't know what you would call that. I guess just not really a drop point. I think that's what they classify it as, but just a slight drop, really. Look at it. Yeah, just a slight drop on it. See what the cutting edge is on this. Yeah, I mean, the cutting edge is 3 1/4. It's got a nice little sharpening choil on it right there. Should be easy to get a hold of. And, you know, actually, really nice grind that they put on this from the factory. It's not a mirror polish on it, but it's pretty close. They did a pretty good job on it, you know. Taiwan made knife. I can't quit playing with the dang thing. I'm going to have to get this in the mail and back to them. But yeah, overall for 30, you know, $35, that's not a bad deal. Let's see what it looks like. We'll get a quick look at the pocket. You see in the pocket there, just a little sticks out. And I feel like something like, let's see. Actually, in all actuality, Mr. Cradduck, if you have, oh, this is the rake clip. But I actually think that would fit on there if you wanted a deep pocket clip. So something like that. And actually, I may have a clip to put on that for you, Mr. Cradduck. I have an extra deep pocket clip that will actually fit on there. Well, maybe I'll stick this on there for you, and then I'll just send both clips with you. So there you go, freebie from me. All right, guys, that's all I really got on this. Really like this thing. Not bad for the money. Good action. It's fun to play with. It's sharp. Fairly nice fit and finish. I mean, you can tell that it's a, you know, it's a cheaper OTF looking at it compared to some of the expensive ones, but is it worth $35? Here's the question. Is it worth $35? Sure. I believe so. If it makes you happy and you've been wanting to play around with one of these. And I mean, I think they have some single actions that are almost running right around the same price. So having a double action, that's a definite plus. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed my intro. I had to get a little nerdy on it. It felt like a Star Wars kind of knife. If I could make it sound like a lightsaber when it opened up, that would be amazing. But all right, everybody. This is Justin from Blue Collar Survival. You guys stay safe.